Connie Martinson Talks Books. I am honored to have with me today Richard Walter. He is, let me say, the expert, the guru, and that's the title of his book, Essentials of Screenwriting. He is professor and screenwriting chairman at UCLA. This is the book, The Art, Craft, and Business of Film and Television Writing, published by Plume. Welcome, Richard.
Thank you. Thank you, Connie.
And what, you know, the funny part is this is a funny, delightful book.
Thank you.
Including some of the stories here that are, you know, true, but funny, as well as learning about having, let's see, the character you write should be, have an identity.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. I think all screenplays, indeed, I think all art, even paintings and sculpture are ultimately a portrait of the artist who created it.
Yeah. And it should have, identified screenplay, that it has integrated all the way through.
Yes, integration is the key. And by that I mean simply that every sight and every sound, and writers need to recognize that that's what a screenplay is. It's just an elaborate list of sight and sound. I can't tell you how many times I read language in screenplays that violates that. Words like realizes, remembers, feels, and so on. So you got to remember, it's just sight and sound. You just have to talk about what people see and what they hear. And if every sight and every sound moves the story forward palpably, measurably, identifiably, gives you new information, it really doesn't matter what the movie's about, what the so-called genre is. And it doesn't matter what happens in the movie. You can even have nothing happen in a scene.
Oh, I loved your talking about Anna Magnani in that film where it could have just been two people sitting
right.
in a room. And she takes off her stocking. She washes them. She hangs it on the line. And
well, she's also Italian, and she's able to wring them out in an Italian way that is expressive and unique to her, and some would say to the Italian people.
Now, something like that, was that in the screenplay, or was that the director, his contribution?
Interesting. I can't tell you precisely, not having looked at the script. Mm. My guess is that that was in the script. However, that because of everything else that's going on, she's in a room that has a sink in the room, and it tells you about the low level of the her economic station and so on. But the notion, you know, drama, the word drama comes from the ancient Greek word meaning to do. It doesn't mean to talk. And you got to give the actors stuff to do. There's a scene that you remind me of a scene I also discuss where in an MGM classic, Young Edison, with Spencer Tracy, my favorite actor, I'm giving away my years, where he and his wife are discussing the next scene where he's going to negotiate with the board of directors of the New York Stock Exchange the sale of the rights to the patent for the stock exchange, and they're talking about how much he should ask for, and is it too much, is it too little, and so on. But she's fixing his tie throughout that scene. And there's great tension in that. In other words, the action does not need to be shooting and looting and car crashes and stuff like that. Although that's okay. There's a lot of that stuff that goes on, even in the classics. But it can also be small, focused, tender, gentle, little stuff that movies are especially adept at handling.
Is that why you say keep the story personal?
Well, I say keep the story personal for the reason that I said earlier. I think every screenplay is a model of a human life, a small beginning, like childhood, a big fat middle, which is our what is sometimes laughingly referred to as adulthood. And then we hope, ideally, a quick ending, and nobody really wants to have a long, drawn-out ending. So that's a model of a human life, and I think there is the question arises, whose human life? And inevitably, it's got to be the life of the writer.
Richard, how many students apply every year?
Well, though, our numbers are soaring. We have well over 1,000 who apply to the film school, but within the screenwriting graduate program, our Master of Fine Arts program, we're getting now north of 400 applications every year for about 24 slots. And these are very good applications. It's a daunting enterprise to fill out the application. A lot of self-selection goes on. We don't get many applications that aren't serious. We actually are in our committee that evaluates these applications actually jumps for joy when we get a really, really bad one that we know we can just dismiss, because we only see about 8 or 10 of those. Otherwise, we'll see hundreds and hundreds of qualified applications, and from those we'll get it down to 100, and then maybe interview about half of those people and disappoint half of those people. So it's quite a blessing, because we get to work with such good writers, but it's not a pleasant experience to be turned away from a program.
Over the years, you have had many students who have won Oscars, who have won Emmys, but you do talk about one who went with a spec script to Who's the Boss?